Hello and welcome to CX Cheat Codes, an Energen podcast series for people passionate about customer experience and user experience with a desire to make an impact for your customers and your organization and build something remarkable. In this podcast series, we work on arming you with the best tips, tricks and tools to help you develop your CX strategy, to find the right solution and manage through all of the complexities of implementation. I'm your host, Oscar Catling, and joining me today is Irina Ashdown, our business analyst and all-around customer experience superstar. Welcome, Irina.
Hi, Oscar.
Today, Irina's going to walk us through the roles and skill set you will need to make your CX transformation a success. You mentioned this would be right for anyone, whether they were just hoping to kick off the CX transformation in the midst of their project or revisiting things after some initial challenges. So why don't you take it away?
Okay, yes. So having the right team on a CX project is a crucial success factor. And this is actually one of the reasons why so many CX transformations fail. It is just simply because of the lack of the right resources with the right skills. And also, I think what's important is to understand the significant difference between CX transformation versus just software implementation. So you have to have very different skill set for this type of projects. It goes without saying that for any CX initiative, you will need a strong implementation technical team that have an established practice, that have been delivering these projects before, and that have sound quality control and a strong solution architect. But what I wanted to focus on today are more those non-technical roles that are also playing the crucial role in the CX transformations. And often those roles are the ones that are underestimated. Okay, for smooth sailing, of course, we need a good captain. And this is your program manager. So the program manager is a person that has quite broad skill set, and these people should be very strategically oriented. For this role to be successful, this person must understand your business, and also they will be dealing in the environment with a lot of moving parts, with a lot of different work streams, and it will be for them to ensure the strategic alignment across the entire transformation that is still and making sure that it's still going in the right direction. And here we should be looking not only for a person with a technical implementation experience and that technical understanding, but also the person who have managed organizational change. And this is what I think makes a big difference in the role of the program manager.
Excellent. Yeah, I can see how the program manager would be really kind of key to any kind of CX transformation. What's next on the list?
All right. So next on the list is the project manager. The project manager is another key role that is usually quite hard to find these people. So similarly to the program manager, their skill set will stretch way beyond the traditional kind of the PRINCE2 definition of the project manager. The project manager, as a minimum, should have the technical knowledge and experience of technology implementation. However, what's more important is being able to assess how well we are progressing, right? So what I'm talking about is not just a simple checking the box and producing the report saying we've completed this task by this day, so great job. It's more it's being able to judge the quality of work that has been done and making decisions and adjust accordingly.
Yeah, so they need a conceptual understanding of the program, not simply a kind of a basic level of kind of, okay, we need to do this here and this there. They really need to kind of understand the details of how it works and what the expectations are.
Exactly. And also another specific complexity specific for customer experience project is that project managers should be able to navigate through dealing with different vendors and system integrators who often might have completely different methodologies and completely different ways of working. And it will be for them to be able to connect these multiple parties to deliver that final product.
Okay, so that makes complete sense. So what's number three?
Number three. So the next role is business analyst and CX strategist.
Ah, well, this is a role you understand really well yourself, right? This is the role that you hold at Energen.
That's true. Yes, I do. And I have been doing this for quite a few years, and I do understand the complexities and challenges that we usually face in the project. So their objective is to define the target state of your customer experience at the low level. And there will be the people communicating this to the implementation team. Business analysts need to have strong communication skills, and they need to be able to speak to the business and really understand their needs to capture it and play it back to the implementation team. It's not just the case of having the workshop and ask the business what their needs are, capture some statement as an answer, and take it away. It's more about being able to drill down into each requirement and really understand what is it that business SMEs are telling you, what the process is that they are describing, and what is the rationale behind it. Mm-hmm. And it's also the job for business analysts and CX strategists to make sure that everything, all the requirements that they captured and that target customer experience state is all aligned with the bigger CX strategy. Often this role and skill kind of attributed more to the development team and the solution architect, especially if the projects are more like operationally oriented, something like CRM implementations. We sometimes don't see this role specifically called out.
Okay.
And sometimes it does work, but what is important is to recognize this as a separate role and as a separate skill. Is that skill being able to talk to the business and really understand what they're saying, and then translate it into this actionable user stories, use cases, requirements, whatever you're using, to the technical team.
Excellent, excellent. I mean, it really does sound like you understand the real nuts and bolts of that role. So what about number four?
Okay, and so the last role for today, which is also non-technical and also very crucial for any CX transformation, is a change lead. I really can't stress this enough, how important it is to invest in the change management before you embark on this whole journey of CX transformation. Doesn't matter whether it's big or small, the project you're doing, you will for sure need someone responsible for change management. So the key skill of this role and this person is being able to assess the change impact correctly, understand the company culture, and find a way to effectively communicate the change into different levels of organization. And that would be through training, through change communications, all these lovely emails and updates that change managers do, different presentations, setting up the support network with the change champions, and many other different ways. The understanding of business processes and the CX strategy is absolutely essential for these people. So often the change managers are seen as the people who just take care of training and send a couple of emails to the business to say, hey, we're live and here's the new solution. But honestly, it's a lot more than that. And as I said, what's important in terms of the skill set for these people is to be able to understand the business processes of where your business is right now, to understand the target state, the future state, and then find the effective way to communicate that change throughout the entire organization.
Yeah, I mean, that makes complete sense, because, you know, there's no sense in investing, you know, thousands into an implementation project just to kind of have that adoption and that change of system kind of fall short at the last hurdle, where, you know, people don't understand the difference to their role, don't understand the difference to the business, and customers don't understand the difference as well. So I think that, you know, highlighting the change lead there is a really key part of this. Okay, great. So that's all we've got time for today. Thank you, Irina, for joining us. You can get in touch with Irina or I directly on LinkedIn, or leave a comment down below to give your thoughts, experiences, and feedback on the roles you have found that have had a profound impact on your CX transformation. Irina, do you have any closing thoughts for us before we close out the podcast?
Closing thoughts. So if you are doing your CX transformation, there is absolutely no need to go and hire an army of different consultants and different contractors. But what's important, I think, is to recognize the key skills for each of those key roles that you need to have on your project. And that's what really helps to have that lean team and efficient team to deliver your customer experience success.
Brilliant. Excellent. Well, thank you very much for joining us, and we'll see you next time.
Thank you.